Welcome to Her Remarkable History. Remember, to support our channel, please subscribe. The horrific child execution of Alice Glaston. Now, Henry VIII is remembered in history for being one of the most ruthless and bloody kings the world has ever seen. During his almost four-decade-long reign on the throne, over 70,000 people were executed within his kingdom. At the time, many criminals were killed for crimes such as murder, arson and theft, and these executions were done publicly. The most shocking execution to have been carried out during Henry VIII's reign is widely believed to have been that of Anne Boleyn's, the king's ill-fated second wife. Anne was executed following the manipulations of Thomas Cromwell, who was tasked with finding the king a way out of his marriage. However, there is one execution which can be considered more shocking than Anne Boleyn's, Thomas Cromwell's and even Thomas More's. In 1546, in the small market town of Much Wenlock in Shropshire, a young 11-year-old girl made her way to the gallows to be hanged. Alice Glaston, it's likely, is the youngest girl to have ever been legally executed in England. A young boy aged 8 or 9 named John Dean was hanged for arson almost a century later. However, much of her story is rather lost to time. Alongside two other people, the young 11-year-old girl was taken into the marketplace of Much Wenlock, alongside two other people, in front of what's presumed a large crowd. She would have been asked for any final words, or to address the crowd. She was then hanged in front of the crowd and executed, and she was just a girl of 11 years of age. However, why did this happen, and what did Alice Glaston do that was so despicable to have condemned a young girl who wasn't even a teenager to death? The parish register of the Vicar of Much Wenlock from 1545 states how here was buried John Dodd of the parish of Little Wenlock, who was hanged here, as also Alice Glaston, 11 years of age, of the parish of Little Wenlock, and William Harper, a tailor. It's not assumed that these three were executed together for committing the same crime, but it is possible. Much Wenlock was a small town, and it's strange that three executions occurred at once. The problem is that the court records from the time and from Alice Glaston's case have been lost to time and have never been discovered. Now, Alice would have been tried at Wenlock Guildhall, which had been built 5 years before following the dissolution of a priory close by that was impacted by Henry VIII's change to religion. On the ground floor of this building was a prison, so it's likely Alice was kept here too. But what crimes in Tudor England could someone possibly be hanged for? As mentioned, murder, theft, and arson were the most common, but it's unlikely that she would have been executed for acts of petty theft. Women were also hung when they were found guilty of treason against the monarchy. But it's surely impossible for an 11-year-old girl to be sentenced to death for plotting to kill the king, especially as the case was dealt with locally. It's likely too that she didn't plot against the king, or dissent against religion too, that resulted in her being declared a heretic, with the standard sentence for this being burning at the stake. Punishment for minor offences in the Tudor period was usually dealt with by whippings, branding, or being locked in the stocks. Those thieves who stole less than a shilling could be whipped and also branded with a hot iron. However, persistent criminals were also locked in the stocks to publicly shame an individual. As Alice Glaston's case went straight for execution, it only leads to a few possible explanations as to what she did. She was either involved in the murder of an individual, possibly a parent or another child, but no other records of burials of young children were found to have been connected in the priest's accounts. Or she was guilty of something much more sinister, which was greatly feared within Tudor society. It is possible that the people of Much Wenlock believed that an 11-year-old Alice Glaston was a witch. It's possible that she could have been found guilty of witchcraft too, and that she was sentenced to death in a harsh way of deterring the public from being involved in these sorts of activities. Now, the problem with the case of Alice Glaston is much left to the speculation due to the lack of concrete evidence that tells us what she actually did. We can imagine what the scene was like in the town centre, with the English public baying for blood of the young girl, waiting and watching with bated breath. and she was handed over to the executioner, who then hanged her. But Tudor England was notoriously brutal. It was within this society that it was deemed acceptable to hang a child for a crime. There was a pattern of this sort of thing happening in English history, as throughout the centuries children were still deemed to have been aware of what they were doing, as the age of criminal responsibility was so low. Even at the age of 7, someone could be held accountable. The story of Alice Glaston is incredibly sad, brutal, and is one that deserves to be told. Thank you for watching, and to support, please subscribe to Her Remarkable History. Thank you.